Hi guys, this is just a quick little video on some pellwork variations. I find pellwork very meditative and soothing, but I have been told that other people find pellwork very boring. So it's always nice to try to mix it up a little bit. So what I'm going to do is show you a couple variations on existing drills and then just give you a pellwork game or two. So the first one is, if we remember, we've been talking a lot about the Meyer four opening drill, and the first four cuts are the upper, lower, lower, upper. We talked about doing that with all leading edge attacks. We've talked about doing it with alternating back edge and leading edge attacks. So we've talked about throwing thrust in the middle. So one thrust, two thrust, three thrust, four thrust. And then we've talked about working in pulling, where you pull a number. So that could be something like one, pull, three, four. But you can also kind of mix all of those up and you have a whole other series of variations. So one thing that you can do is definitely with all lead edge, one thrust, two thrust, three thrust, four thrust, back edge cuts, back thrust, true thrust, back thrust, true thrust, and true thrust, back thrust, true thrust, back thrust. Just putting in those back edge on either side with the thrust makes a difference. And then with the pulling, you can, of course, with all lead edge, one, two, pull the three, and four. But if we work in the back edge cuts, that adds a whole other set of variations. So now I can come back edge, pull back edge, and attack. Or true edge, pull true edge, and then back edge. So if you start adding back edges and then the pulling, you're gonna find yourself probably in some kind of awkward positions. So if I'm coming true, 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 pull, true, true, and then we come back, pull, back, true, and then true, pull, true, back. You can see that you start mixing it up and you can kind of brain fry yourself a little bit, but it also is a nice way to find some kind of hitches in your motion where it doesn't feel as natural or flowy, or your body doesn't really want to go that way, and figure out how to make that happen. And so go slow, definitely pick a series of things you want, variations you want to work on, work your way through those until they're smooth. That should give you a whole other way to play with the Meyer four opening drill and some of the pulling and thrusting things that we've done before. It's part of why I like this diagram so much, is the more you play with it, the more you can find variations that give you new ways to drill with your sword. In terms of pell games, one of my favorites is a deck of cards. This is something we use in the HEMA club as well. So if you're familiar with Meyer, he talks about his four types of fencers. And I always say that they are essentially a spectrum of aggressiveness. So your type one is the buffalo, the run in and smash guy. How do you deal with that? Number two is what I like to call the double kill machine. You know, they're gonna shoot for openings whether it's really safe for them to do so or not. It's number two. Number three is kind of the artful fencer. He's only gonna hit you if he's pretty sure he can get you and he's pretty sure he can cover. Meyer says mostly be number three. And then number four is the very, very defensive fighter. And Meyer says that you are either a master or a fool if you just stand there and parry all the time, because you either have to be perfect or you're dead. But Meyer does say you should be able to be all four types of fencers depending on the situation. But all of us have natural tendencies. I tend to be, for the most part, a type three or four fencer, particularly if I'm fencing somebody I don't really know. And it's hard to push myself out of that. So what we do with the deck of cards is we'll actually shuffle it, and we'll have, when people go out to do a practice bout, they'll pull a card, and depending on the suit that you pull, you have to be that type of fencer. So maybe kings are the hyper-aggressive fencer for this round. Maybe queens are the super defensive fighter. And the nice thing is that you pull that card, you don't show it to your partner, you go out and spar a set, 5-10 passes, whatever. Both of you are trying to be the type of fencer that you were assigned, and also figure out what type of fencer your opponent is enacting, what kind of fighter they're bringing you. That's really awesome. It's a super fun drill. It pushes you out of your comfort zone, forces you to try to be aware of what your opponent is doing, and that's great. If you're stuck at home and you don't have a partner, one of the things I do with the deck of cards is I will assign either a particular cut, if it's a newer fighter, to a suit. and then you shuffle it and you pull it out, and then the number of the card is how many of those you have to do. So let's say that I'm fairly new and I have said that Oberhaus are spades, Unterhaus are hearts, Middlehaus are clubs, and thrusts are whatever suit I just left out. And you pull a six of hearts. Well, you have to do six of that cut, right? It's just a way to, you have slightly different pellwork every day. You don't have to do the whole deck of cards if you don't want. You could shuffle them and pull the first 10, whatever you're doing. If you're a little bit more advanced than that, you can set up combinations or plays and say, okay, I pulled a four of hearts. I have to do four of this set, whether it's a thrust to cut or a cut to thrust or Meyer's first longsword play, if that's what you want to do, or the first Zorn or play out of Ringek. But it gives you a set number of those things to do. Could do it with the sword and buckler plays that I'm doing in the other videos. You could say that each of the suits of cards is one of the first four plays, and you have to do that many of them. It's just a way to kind of mix it up a little bit. Another thing I have done, and this one is a little more gimmicky, but it can be kind of fun. I used to box, and I still punch the heavy bag for cardio and for fun. And I have a little boxing app on my phone, and it calls out combinations. And since we have talked about in other videos, the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, you can, instead of throwing like a jab, cross, hook, you can hit the target of the numbers that it pulls out. So if the boxing trainer pulls out 1, 2, well then you attack 1, 2. They call out 3, 4, 3, then you attack that. And it's just a way to mix it up a little bit. It gets you to be a little reactive. And those are just some games to try, along with the variations that I just talked about, that should spice up your pellwork if you find yourself getting a little stagnant.